The White House not denying a report that the Biden administration has been secretly flying thousands of unaccompanied migrant children from Texas to the New York City area. The New York Post is calling it Biden's secret flight. That's clever. And it's reporting that 2,000 children have been flown from our southern border and sent to drop-off points in New Jersey, New York, and Connecticut. This seems like a good story for Peter Doocy to ask the White House about.
Why is the administration flying thousands of migrants from the border to Florida and New York in the middle of the night?
Well, I'm not sure that it's in the middle of the night, but let me tell you what's happening here.
4:29 a.m.
Well,
early in the morning.
Here we are talking about early flights, earlier than you might like to take a flight. In recent weeks, unaccompanied children passed through the Westchester Airport, which I think is what you're referring to, en route to their final destination to be unified with their parents or vetted sponsor.
And since Democrats love fairness and equity, Ted Cruz has an idea on where to put the massive influx of migrants.
Their entire political strategy is based on secrecy. What is happening at our southern border is an absolute tragedy. I've introduced legislation today in the Senate. It's called the Stop the Surge Act. Well, what my bill does is it designates new ports of entry so rich Democrats can be sitting there and suddenly see 10, 20, 30, 50,000 illegal immigrants like we're seeing in Texas on a daily basis, and I can just envision them in Nantucket sipping a martini going, oh goodness, they want to come to our clubs. They would be horrified.
You know, Dana, that was from America's Newsroom. It's a show that's on
great
earlier
job.
In the day.
Yep.
Yeah, okay. This seems like something that we cooked up, which means it's good, right? The port of entry at Martha's Vineyard. I swear one of us has probably said this, but it's actually, it's very clever because obviously it's made the news, but also it's kind of legitimately correct.
Yeah. And he makes a he made the point this morning that, and we've been saying this too, President Biden never gone to the border. Kamala Harris is in charge of the border, doesn't go. And when you, let's say that there's a natural disaster, what's one of the first things a president does? Goes down, surveys the damage, sees what is going on, so that when he or she eventually gets back, they can say, okay, we need to do the emergency declaration. This is what they're going to need. And I'm going to make sure, you make sure that they get everything that they need. They just ignore this. And what's interesting is President Trump had taken all this grief, right, for all the things on immigration. And all President Biden had to do was maintain the status quo.
Right.
But instead, they did a Twitter poll, basically, and made policy based on that. And what you end up having is it's poisoned the well against the need and demand for legal immigration. People who are here waiting in line, trying to get it done legally, and it just has completely made it the issue toxic. The other thing is, because of the Flores Agreement, stick with me, the children cannot be held, unaccompanied minors cannot be held for longer than 30 days. So Customs and Border Patrol has to send them somewhere. They give them to Health and Human Services, and that department takes off. You'll be talking about Pete Buttigieg and where he's been. Where in the world is Secretary Becerra? It's like, is he in the witness protection program?
Yeah, they're all missing. They're all on milk cartons.
Yeah.
It's amazing. Harold, why doesn't the Democrats actually take Cruz at his suggestion or the bill? Because share the responsibilities. I mean, I think that would make a lot of people happy, Republicans happy, if it looked like the non-border privileged share some of the responsibility.
So you would presumably still have to put people on a plane to take them to these places. So we would have the issue we had with this. And they went to Westchester, which is, I'm sure, the people in and around those communities in New Canaan and Darien and Greenwich probably would not want the same thing that Ted Cruz is trying to suggest there. Look, Ted, can you imagine 40 years ago, 30 years ago, Dana, sitting United States Senator joking like Senator Cruz did there? I think Senator Cruz is a serious guy, he's a smart guy, he's a well-educated guy. But let's get serious. We have a problem at the border. If you want to force Democrats and shame Democrats, shame them with policy. I've said on the show before, I've laid out what I think is a predicate. I've laid out that I think, I hate to say this on a day where Secretary Mayorkas wish him the best, and my prayers are with him and his family as he's dealing with COVID-19 positive tests. But we've got to get a serious person there who can manage this crisis and who's willing to negotiate with Republicans. And as much as this may get some nice headlines here for Senator Cruz and we get a nice chuckle from it, you still have to fly people to Martha's Vineyard and to the Hamptons and to all the other places he wants.
But I think
his larger point is the right one. We've got to incentivize Democrats to want to be more serious about this. And it seems like we may need to have Republicans.
He went on to say that he knows that the Democrats aren't going to move it forward. He is making a point, and sometimes that's why you do stuff like
exactly,
this.
Exactly, exactly. You know, Katie, why do you think these flights were at night? Who were they hiding from? They're not hiding from CNN because they're not covering it. They did those flights because of Fox. That's my theory.
Maybe they did. Maybe they got that idea from you, Greg, because you're so brilliant.
Oh, thank you.
But on the issue of policy, I will point out that Senator Lindsey Graham, and I can't remember which Democratic senator, actually offered up the suggestion that Jay Johnson, who's the former DHS secretary under Obama, come in and manage the border crisis because the vice president is clearly not doing that and Democrats didn't take him up on that. But I think when you look at what's happening here, they're flying people in the middle of the night, hoping that people don't notice, even though they can see what's happening. What's going on here is the American taxpayer is subsidizing human trafficking. They are finishing the final leg of human trafficking. So what happens is in South America, say you're from El Salvador, someone pays for an unaccompanied minor to get taken to the border. HHS gets them after being processed through Border Patrol. And then the American taxpayer is footing the bill for these people to be put on planes and flown all over the country. I'm not really sure why, if we can fly them from the border to New York, why we can't fly them from the border to El Salvador or back to where they came from to reunite them with their families there. Apparently, that's not on the table. But lawmakers have been sounding the alarm on this for months. They were flying through Tennessee, and Senator Marsha Blackburn said, what are you guys doing? You're secretly putting these flights into our communities, which, by the way, federal government's not giving the resources to handle these people. And they lied about it. And now that they've been caught, they're trying to grapple with whether it's in the middle of the night or at 4 a.m. Yeah. Mm.
Jesse, anything I'm doing at 4 a.m. can't be good.
That's exactly my point. Anybody that does something in the middle of the night in secret.
Unless they're garbage men.
They're not proud of that.
Yes.
You're not proud of that. No one's proud of what you're doing in secret in the middle of the night. Joe knows he's wrong. He knows he's wrong. He feels guilty about it. And that's why he's hiding this like a coward. Own it. Make your case to the American people. Said this is what we're doing. This is the policy. And we're going to do it in daylight. But he won't. Because he can't, because he knows if people know about this policy, the country's going to be appalled. And that's why no one besides Fox will report this. If you ask Jen Psaki about this and she doesn't give you an answer, here's some follow-up questions. You can't vet sponsors and relatives after what you did in Afghanistan. We didn't even get our guys out of Afghanistan. We couldn't even vet an army after 20 years. And now you know that these sponsors are vetted. You know these are the real parents. Come on, you don't know that. This is taxpayer-funded human trafficking. Who are these people that they're giving them to? Who are these agencies that are getting these fat federal contracts to receive these teenagers? Who are they? She can't answer that question, and she needs to be asked that question. Americans can't even get on flights because they're being canceled because of vax mandates. But you're going to give illegals free flights, free food. He's advertising to the entire Western Hemisphere, cross our border if you're under 18. We're going to fly you to Miami. We're going to fly you to New York. This is crazy. This is crazy. I don't think things are right up there.
I just wonder. This is wrong. It's still weird, the timing. Why does it have to be at 4 a.m.?
Why do you think? Yeah. He's not even telling the governors he's doing this.
Yeah.
Well, and it's very
He doesn't
organized.
Want anybody to know.
If you see these people in the airport, they're all wearing the same thing. They all have the same paperwork, and they have a handler, and they're not allowed to talk to anybody. So it's a very organized effort, and someone's getting paid.
All right.
Yeah, it's terrible, but let's not speculate too much. But I would agree with the premise. This is not the way to do this.
Yeah. All right. Up next, Democrats forced to scale back their plans on the IRS snooping around in your bank account.